Hi everyone, this is Gurmete, and today we are preparing Mamaliga. Mamaliga, better known by its Italian name Polenta, it's a very popular Romanian dish. It can be called Romanian cornmeal porridge if you want, and it can be made with 3 or 4 simple ingredients. If you are new to my channel and you like my videos, don't forget to subscribe. Also, click on the notification bell to be the first to know when I post a new video. If you are an old subscriber, thank you for returning. Although the white cornmeal is available nowadays, the Romanian polenta is normally made with a yellow cornmeal, and I highly recommend to use a non-GMO cornmeal. My parents and grandparents used to do this polenta in a ceaun, which is a round-bottom kettle, but I don't have one. We can use, instead of that ceaun, a cast iron pot, or if you have, a ceramic pot. We also gonna need a whisk, a wooden spoon, or a facalet, which is a wooden rod of about 30 centimeters. Combine 1 teaspoon of salt and 1 liter of water in your chosen pot, in my case is the ceramic pot, and bring to a boil. 250 to 300 grams of cornmeal, depending on how thick you want your polenta, and 1 tablespoon of butter. You can replace the butter with oil of your choice or skip it completely. If skipped, you will make a Romanian polenta with only 3 ingredients, water, cornmeal and salt. When the water starts boiling, turn the heat on medium and sprinkle the cornmeal into the water, stirring continuously with a whisk. Use caution, since the mixture at this stage bubbles up and splatters hot polenta around. To avoid splatters of hot polenta, I use a grease splatter screen. If you don't have a splatter screen, feel free to use the pot lid. Continue cooking for 30 to 40 minutes, mixing from time to time. The cooking time depends on the cornmeal, the pot used, and the heat source. Now it's time to add the butter. I added 1 tablespoon. Mix well to incorporate the butter with the cornmeal. As I said before, you can skip this step or make some replacements. If the cornmeal needs more time to cook, put the lid on and let the polenta cook for a few more minutes. You will know your polenta is ready when it thickens and it starts to pull away from the sides of the pot, like you see in this video. Transfer the polenta from the cooking pot to a wooden board or on a wooden table to cool and harden. Usually, a wooden spoon dipped in a cold water or a piece of string is used to cut the hardened Romanian polenta. The recipe that I prepared today is for 4 to 5 people. But feel free to double the quantities so you can make a bigger polenta. Here is an example of the polenta cut with a wooden spoon. And this is an example of the polenta cut with a string. You can use a softer polenta to prepare polenta in layers. Recipe in the description box. Romanian polenta can be served as a side for multiple dishes. I have here some examples. As a modern twist, not a traditional way, you can bake or fry the polenta and have yourself some modern dishes. You can always add some herbs like parsley, rosemary or thyme to make a herb polenta, but this is not the Romanian traditional way to cook it. You must give this Romanian polenta a try. It can get more Romanian than this. Enjoy it to the family and friends. Thank you for watching my recipe. If you like it, give it a like and share it with the world. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel for more healthy dishes every week. See you in the next one.